Okay, this is going to be a two-page video to help with the problem involving pH changes, because we have to calculate the pH before and the pH after. So, when it asks for pH change, delta pH, any chemistry has pH final minus pH initial. Okay, so I am trusting that you realize that initially the pH before anything is added of pure water is 7. Okay, we need to find out what is the pH of 480 mL of water when we add 15 mL of 2.1 molar HCl to it. Okay, so the scenario here is that we have 480 mils of water, and we're going to add 15 mils of 2.1 molar HCl, which, as you know, is pretty much as good as adding hydronium. So I'm betting the pH is going to drop, okay? Now, in this case, since we really don't have anything much to react with, no bases or anything, the way to do this is to realize this is a dilution problem, really. Okay? C1V1 equals C2V2. Initially, we start out with 2.1 molar and 15 mils of material. Okay? We would like to know what's the concentration afterward, because that'll give us the hydronium concentration. And be careful with your V2, okay? It's going to be 480 mils of water and the 15 mils we started out with. So that is going to be 495 mils. Okay, very well. We shall type this into our calculator and solve for X. And it turns out that X is equal to 0.06363 repeating molar. Okay? And don't forget that X is being used to represent our hydronium concentration. So I'm trusting that you believe you could get the pH from taking the negative log of the hydronium concentration. So that would be 0.06363 log. And I get a pH of 1.196. So I will put this in as my final, as 1.20 minus 7.00. So, you know, notice that you do get a negative number, okay? You do get a negative 5.80 as the pH change. That's the first one. Okay, what about the second one? The second one, again, pH, delta pH, is going to be equal to pH final minus pH initial. Initially, I appear to just have some base in water. Because isn't acetate a base? And it's a weak base. So, you know what? There's a shortcut formula, isn't there? Can't I determine that if I have a base in water, that a lot of times the hydroxide concentration can be equal to the Kb times the original concentration of the base. So all I need to do is figure out the Kb of acetate. I know that my Ka of acetic acid is equal to 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5. So my Kb has to be equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14 divided by 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, which turns out to be 5.55 repeating forever times 10 to the minus 10. So my hydroxide concentration should be equal to 5.55 times 10 to the minus 10th times a 0.01. So that is times 0.1 equal to 7.45 times 10 to the minus 6th. Okay, now hopefully you know what to do from here, right? I've got a hydroxide concentration. It's 7.45 times 10 to the minus 6th. I think I should take the log of that value. So negative log of 7.45 times 10 to the minus 6th will give me a 5.13, which is equal to my pOH. And that means my pH is equal to 8.87. All right, I have my initial. I will put it up here. It is 8.87. Okay, so I'll just draw a little line here so we can get to work on the other one. All right, now, what about after we add the acid? Well, base and strong acid are going to react, so I think I'm going to have to come up with a reaction table, okay? So I have hydronium, and I'm going to react it with my base, and I'm not quite sure what the equilibrium arrow should look like to begin with, but I should have water and C2H3O2. Aqueous. Okay. My hydronium amount is going to be 15 mils times 2.1 molar. My acetate amount is going to be 480 mils and 0.10 molar. So I guess this is 48 millimoles. And 15 times 2.1 gives me 31.5 millimoles. Alrighty. Well, whenever you have a strong acid react with a weak base, it is going to be one of those that slams to the right again, 100%. You can check me if you want. Take the K of the reacting acid over the K of the produced acid. You'll find out it's pretty big, okay? So we are once again going to treat this like a limiting reagent problem. Minus 31.5, minus 31.5, and plus 31.5. Okay, so that is zero. This is 31.5 and 48.0 minus 31.5. gives me 16.5 millimoles. Now, take a look at what you have. You have a weak base, and you have its conjugate weak acid. Do we not call that a buffer? I think we do. So, pH is equal to pKa plus log of base over acid. All right, the pKa of acetic acid is 4.74. Oops, I don't know what. There, 4.74 plus the log. My base is my 16.5 millimoles. My acid is my 31.5 millimoles. And if I put that all into my calculator, it comes out to 4.46. All right. Now, I'm not quite done because I'm looking for pH difference. So I need to take this value, which was final, and this value, which was initial, and take 4.46 minus 8.87. And I wind up with a minus 4.41. All right, that's parts A and B. Another movie is needed for parts C and D.